Hi brothers and sisters, my name is Eric Bison, and I just sat this Friday morning and I'm just thinking about the hurricane in Cameroon. You know, I'm just thinking about as an individual, as a citizen, realistically we have to be healthy in order to be productive. Realistically, we all have to get good health before we can do anything better with our lives, with our generation, with our country. If we're not in good health, there's no way we can show that positive inside of our country. You know, some of us are fortunate to travel abroad, you know, to study. Some of us, being abroad, we get that health care. We can take care of ourselves. But my question is, to our leaders in our country, you know, even you embezzle money, you know, there's no way I can get you on that. But as a human being, you know, created by God, if you embezzle money, at least if you use that money for a good purpose, like giving good health to the people, knowing that, okay, the citizens of Cameroon need to stay healthy. You know, as a leader, if you stay, you're in power, and you've been negatively looked upon by other people, by your citizens, nobody wants to stay in Cameroon because my leader has been there forever. You know, I think if you get to that point, you ask yourself, is it something I can do to help my people? Is it something I can do to change the life of my people? Is it something I can do to make my people understand that, you know what, I can change too. I can be a better person. You know, like investing in the healthcare, like traveling to all the clinics and hospitals in the rural areas. I see how badly these structures are, how they have lack of equipment, how they have lack of medication stock to take care of the people. At the same time, you ask the people to pay for care that they don't even have in the first place. You don't go door to door in the rural areas and ask this mother, how do you do when you're pregnant or when you're about to give birth? How do you do it? Where do you, what is your platform? Where do you give birth? How is your maternity? How is that going? Asking that young girl, you are pregnant at the age of 12. What happened? What should you do? What can we do to avoid other young girls not to get pregnant at that age? What can we do to invest on health education of the woman, of the young man? What can we do to make sure that the people stay healthy so that we have a generation? Because, I mean, you're in power. You're a government leader. You want to lead people. But do you want to lead sick people? Do you want to lead age zero population if all your people are dying out of unknown sicknesses? Things or sickness that can be prevented in the first place. Do you ask yourself those questions, leaders of Cameroon? Do you ask yourself all the economics, all the citizens of Cameroon? Do we ask ourselves those questions? Yes, some of us are fortunate to be in the diaspora. Some of us are fortunate to have this health care. Living in the United States, for example, I know that, okay, there's health insurance. I work and I pay for that health insurance. But I'm being taken care of. When I go to the hospital, they don't tell me, you know what, we need your money first before we even ask you, okay, what is wrong with you? They take care of me before they even ask me if I have insurance. They take care of me before they even bail me. Yes, it's a developed country. But Cameroon has natural resources that we can develop. Our government leaders embezzle money. It's not that we don't have the money. We have them. People, we do. But people don't know so much about Cameroon in the diaspora or abroad because they've never heard Cameroon fighting a war. They never heard Cameroon being in any trouble. They know Cameroon in the positive aspect only when it comes to soccer. Yes. But our people are fighting a war internally. A war that we ask our leaders, why should we fight a war internally when we have resources, when we have leaders embezzling money? You know, use this money that you embezzle to take care of your people's health. Take this money that you embezzle to chip in the health education of your people in the rural areas. We see mothers trying to give birth, rushing to the hospital in wheelbarrows. How is that possible? Why should that be that way? Why should I carry my mother in a wheelbarrow because she's about to give birth? When she's about to give birth, what should she do? How should I take control of that if I don't have the money? Or if I don't have the best or the medical support that I could have to take care of her? How can I be productive if I'm sick in a country like Cameroon? How can I be productive? How can I lead to that development in that country? How can I lead to productivity of that country if I'm sick? My leader, please tell me. leaders of Cameroon, if you stay in power for 50 years, that's fine. But use that 50 years to emphasize or to invest in the healthcare of your people to make sure that our Cameroonians stay healthy in our rural areas. Our Cameroonians stay healthy in, even in our urban areas. Because Cameroon young people are the ones developing our nation, especially our young girls. We need to emphasize on health education of our young girls or education of our young girls. We need to make sure that our young girls go to school. We need to make sure that our mothers learn what is health education of the women. We need to make our mothers understand that breast ironing is a bad thing by investing on education, going door to door, making them understand that breast ironing is not the way to prevent your daughter from having sex or from guys looking at her. Instead, you are destroying that young girl's life. You are destroying that young girl's future. So what can we do? These are the kind of things that our leader, the money that you invest, these are the kind of things you can do to, you know, to work on those things, because it is very important. We need to fill out our clinics and hospitals with best and rejuvenated or modern equipment or health equipment or health supplies. We need to emphasize on the education, door-to-door education of our people. We need to fight malaria. We need to fight malnutrition. Those things. We need to even explain to the people what is malnutrition, what is cholera, what is elephantiasis. How can you fight it? How can you prevent it from happening to the next generation? Those are the kind of things that our leader, please. We need to talk about it. We need to emphasize about it. But more and more, we need to act on it, because this is time for action. It's not the time for sitting and talking. This is not the time for sitting and trying to be the best at corruption, being the best at giving good healthcare to the people of Cameroon. This is what we have to do. This is what our people need, good health. So let's forget about those talking. Let's do action. Let's work on action. Cameroonian people in the diaspora, join hands. Let's join hands together. We can do this. We are in a diaspora where we work in hospital, we work in clinics. We can make it such a way that we talk to those people. Not at forming NGOs, but talk to them and see how we can get the equipment that they have here that they consider expired that can still be used to treat our people back home. Make it such a way that our people don't have to come to the US to get treatment. Our parents don't have to come to the US to get treatment. We can give them those treatment back at home if we educate our nurses. Not educate our nurses by giving them surveys, by giving them questionnaires to answer. That is just formal education. That's not practical nursing education. We need to give them proper nursing education on infection control, on disease control, on healthcare control, on maternal control, on birth control. We need to emphasize on those kind of things. Those are the things that our people need. And that is why I decided to form Mary Grace Healthcare Foundation, because we are going to emphasize on those things. Even I have to walk barefoot in the United States to make sure that I get those medical supplies to invest in clinics and hospitals in the right areas of Cameroon, then that's what I'm going to do. I want to leave a good legacy for my children. Know that their dad made it possible for this kid in Cameroon to get good health, for this young girl in Cameroon to get good health. We can do this. It is not impossible. God gave us the strength. He gave us the energy. He gave us the knowledge. Let's use it. Corrupted leaders in Cameroon, use that money to work on the healthcare of our people. That's just all we ask. Because when we are healthy, we'll work. Although you will measure the money again later, but at least we are healthy, working for the productivity of Cameroon. This is the time for action. Yep, let's do it. It is simple. So join me at MaryLouiseHealthcareFoundation.com. Let's make this happen. Like I said, it is a young organization, and I'm passionate about her. Having gone through an experience of losing two people in 1 year. Are you serious? That is my mother and my sister in 1 year. From unknown sickness, at least you have to take in my head that, Eric, you need to do something. Eric, you need to work hard to make sure that another mother or another sister doesn't go through that same issue. So join us on February 22nd on our teleconference. Let's talk about this. Check on the information more on our website or on Facebook. See how you can join the teleconference February 22nd at 5 p.m. Eastern Time. If you're a doctor, a nurse that wants to join the discussion, join us and let's talk about healthcare in Cameroon and see how action needs to be done. This is Action Time. Thank you, and may God bless you all. Thank you.